Okay, quick tour of our stage at Busch Gardens. I'm going to start with the cool stuff, the guitar gear. That's the cool stuff. Here's my rig. Eggnator, Tweaker 88. Nice bunch of settings, because guitar guys can't ever get enough switches and knobs to play with. And then this is our personal mixer. It's our Behringer system. And this allows us to mix our own personal mixes in our ear. And that's a real big help. I have my inner mix really low, really comfortable, and I hear everything really clear. I got the other guitar player on one side, on the other, drums in the center. It makes for hearing what everybody's doing hassle-free. Guitar, since I sold my Les Paul recently, I am back to using an old 90s metal Jackson soloist, Necrubani, until I get a suitable guitar for this gig. This guitar actually is great for this gig. It just looks very heavy metal, but whatever. And then over here is Paulie's rig. Bass, head, personal mixer. Here's Jody's setup. Sax flute. He's got a little mixer over there and his personal mixer up top. Down here is my pedal board. Foot switch for the Tweaker 88. Line 6 M13 for multi-effects. And a boring old volume pedal. Over here we have Tony's setup. He's got a little monitor wedge set up in addition to his in-ears because the drums have a partition around them to keep them quiet. So here you see Tony's keyboard set up. It's just a Yamaha keyboard inside a shell. The shell Tony actually built himself. There you go, grandstand. Tony's personal mixer for his in-ears. Little scrolling lyrics in case you need them. And over here we have the Fullerton. There's multi-effects unit. Bunch of unnecessary stomp boxes. Right, Fullerton? And then his amp. His personal mixer, some wireless gear, and a rack full of instruments. He's got a nice carbon here. I'll probably end up ordering one of these sometime later in the year. Make up for my Les Paul. Acoustic and a backup electric in case one of us loses our guitar on stage, breaks a string or something. Over here we have our in-ear mix monitor system. And it's a nice big mixer, 32 track mixer. All our signals come into this. We do everything ourselves. We bring our own mics, our own cables, and all our signals go into a splitter, which is down here, which I can't get to, but from back here. So what happens is the signals come in, they split off to the house, and then the other half goes into our personal mixer. So what we do with our in-ear mix has nothing to do with goes to the front of house engineer. And it makes things super easy to set up. The engineers love it. There's really no need for monitor wedges on stage, unless in this case, because Jeff has the partition around him, Tony asked for a wedge. But this has made things so much easier and so much more pleasant. Not only does it protect your ears from getting crushed on stage, you can hear everything super clear. They hear their background vocals nice. I hear the other guitar player really well. And if you want to, you have the option of dumping off multi-track to a laptop and we can listen to later and see who's slacking. Probably Dave. And then over here is Greg's setup. A couple of different keyboards. I'm not sure what he's using. Roland Phantom X6, Yamaha, don't know. Some triggers. Triggers awesome. Sounds like the beginning of Allentown with the steam whistle blowing in the background. Maybe a phone ringing like in the beginning of Fantasy, or glass breaking in Still Rock and Roll With Me. No, that's not it. I can't remember the name of the song. You may be crazy. You may be right. That's what it is. You may be forgetful. Okay. And then down here is Greg's personal mix. And up here, he keeps a little personal monitor. I think he may only have one in here that you said at the time. and then we'll take you over to Jeff's big monster setup. He's using soul tone drums, soul tone cymbals. These cymbals sound great. A whole array of cymbals here. We got a full mic'd up kit, snare. Look at these tom mics. They're awesome. Tiny little tom mics. And then we got overheads. I think these overheads really help because I can hear the ride cymbal during, let's say, a jazz sequence in Zanzibar. It allows for a nice clear drumming in our in-ears. And then Jeff has his own personal mixer as well. So he gets a nice kit mix in his ear and whatever else he needs to hear. And then just in a close-up of Jody's personal mixer, and I guess he's got a mixer here bringing in some iwi and various sax and background vocal settings. And that's it. That's the Turnstiles setup. And here's our room today. It's a little quiet right now because we're going to be seeing shows. But it's a big room. Fills up nicely. People go there, get their food, come in here, sit down. We've had some really huge crowds in here. Very energetic crowd. It's been great. And that's it. This is our last day. Got two shows to go, and we're back home.